Every year around this time, and this time is May turning into June, these thoughts occur to me, and it goes this way. What Vermont living is like for me. In the seasons of April and May, Vermont, the snow is gone, the days are getting longer, it's getting warmer, you don't have to build a fire every night, you don't have to worry about firewood, and you can start to see the earth kind of break open. You can start to smell the wetness of the soil, and it is so satisfying. So I always feel like that's the beginning of my interest in Vermont. The next thing that happens is the summer. The summer comes on and is gone really, really fast, and that's when everything seems to explode. You know, the peonies explode, and then there are just rivers of different blooms that happen over that period of time. No fires to make, minimal work outdoors, lots of sitting outside, the days are long, the sunlight is fantastic, and I am fully in love. I am passionately in love with Vermont. There's nothing that could ever break us apart. The next thing that happens is the fall. The fall is beautiful. The color, the smells, the food. All of a sudden you want to make stews and bake bread and that kind of thing. And fall is probably my favorite month of all. And again, very, very short season here in Vermont. But by that time, I feel like we've settled into a deep and sustaining relationship with Vermont. I feel like it's that same thing as being in a long-term relationship with a human being. They can do no wrong. You're happy in their company. Everything's good. The next thing that happens is December still encountered in a bit of that long-term relationship, because there's lights, it hasn't been cold for very long, you kind of like the fire going in the fireplace, you're still all in. And then January through March happens, the 3 months of January through March, and it starts with discontent. The discontent comes because it's cold. It's really, really cold. Near the wood stove, it's warm, but you know, you venture too far away from there and it's cold. Keeping the fire going is a pretty constant thing. You get very closed in. The roads become very difficult. People stop visiting each other. The days are short and dark. And this is when I start to question my love affair with Vermont. I start to think, why do I live here? I could live in Hawaii or anywhere. And so I start questioning this relationship with Vermont. And then, so that happens in January. And by February, I have serious doubts. I am ready for deep, intense counseling with Vermont. I need to understand where it's coming from. I just don't really get why this is happening. So that's February. It's a little bit of confusion, but for me, I would call it overall discontent. And then March comes. In March, I am filing for divorce from Vermont. I want no part of it. I want out. I'm tired of being cold. I'm tired of the days being long. Because March here is exactly February, just done over again. And it's a long month. And so by March, I'm really done. I'm really, really done. And I think I'd like to live almost anywhere that was more easy. Just easy, because by that time, I'm tired of it, I'm over it, I'm done. So March happens, and I start floating these theories all the time, which I'll tell you in the second story why I'm telling you this first story first. And then, so March is over, and what comes after March, of course, is March, April. April, the earth sort of breaks open, and I begin the cycle again, and it begins with infatuation, and then with passion, and then long-term relationshiping with Vermont, and then the winter comes again and I'm ready to divorce and I want out. And this is my cyclical thing that I do every year. So right now I am deep in the passionate part. Vermont can do no wrong. I love it and everything about it. And when you drive around, all you see is beauty. You know, it's the most beautiful place you could ever be. Just green everywhere. Just perfect. But anyway, so that brings me to the second story I wanted to tell you. So the second story, I'm calling the second story 23 minutes. So I had been complaining during that period of time between January and March to my significant other about how much I really was kind of done with living here. You know, we really could downsize. We could live in a place that was easier on both of us, blah, blah, you know, like this all the time. And we both really love being here, which is why I have sort of safe space in order to voice his opinions, because I know we're never going anywhere. But for my husband, there are the trails nearby. We have the dogs. It's really, really quiet. I mean, there's some wonderful all-season reasons for being here. So anyway, so 23 minutes. Why is the story called 23 minutes? So we're driving into town yesterday because we're going to get something at the pharmacy. We're going to pick up some food, put some gas in the car. And, you know, it's a regular errand. And so I said to him, you know, gee, you want me, you know, want some company? You know, I'm along. I'll just go with you. And he said, yeah, so come along. So we're getting near town. And I turned to him and I say, 23 minutes. And he said, what about 23 minutes? And I said, well, 23 minutes. Anytime we get in the car and we want to go somewhere or do something, it's basically 23 minutes. It's really closer to 25. So I said, 23 minutes in, you do whatever it is you want to do, and then 23 minutes out. And I said, so all, Ed, no matter what you do, it's always an hour you can never get back, right? Sort of hammering home my point that I was trying to make between January and March. A little tongue-in-cheek and also a little like, wow, here we are in the car again, 23 minutes, right? So we do what we're gonna do. We'll go to the pharmacy, we get the food, we get the gas and everything. And what I forgot to mention is that it's very crowded. It's Memorial Day weekend, and so there was a lot of crowded for Vermont is like nothing, but it means there are other cars on the road, basically. And so, you know, we had to wait a little bit of time at the pharmacy, and we had to, you know, wait a little bit online for the gas, and everything was just a little slower. We didn't hit every traffic light, and then, you know, it took probably more than 23 minutes. And, you know, we were both commenting on how, gosh, it's so busy, and there are other cars, and you know, we really just want, now that we've done our errand, we really just wanted to get home. And so, as we're exiting the town, and things are starting to fall away, you know, now there are less cars. And Tom, with exquisite timing, turned to me and he said, and now, he said, 23 minutes. And I said, what about 23 minutes? He goes, and now we're 23 minutes away from all of that. And aren't you grateful? Oh my God, I laughed so hard because that was so true. I'm so happy to be 23 minutes away from all of that when I want to be away from it. As much as I am 23 minutes wanting to be closer to it when I want to be closer to it. So I said to him, after laughing really hard, I said, oh my gosh, you know, did you hold on to that joke all the way? You know, did you know you were going to say that on the way back? And he said, no, it just occurred to him. But I thought the timing was great. And I thought it made a really good story. You know, it was set in good humor. And, you know, I really appreciate that. Now, the third thing that I want to say is I think the peonies are going to bloom this coming week. So I'm talking to you on Friday, right before Memorial Day, and I think next week is the week they're gonna bloom. And you know, they're all gonna explode at the same time. And I'm gonna have to get really, really busy. I've been putting it off and I haven't been putting it off, it's just that they haven't been blooming. The minute they bloom, then I wanna stay up all night painting them. And that's what next week's gonna be. So thank you for listening to my little stories. And remember to keep the white to your paper white, your paints wet, math for value, mix for color. And please join my YouTube channel if you haven't done it yet. All right, see you next time. Bye-bye.